Good morning, everybody. I trust you well this morning. It's good to be with you, and I hope you got out of the right side of the bed this morning. That's a little bit silly, isn't it? Because a lot of beds are kind of up against the wall, and you haven't got much option. But I really trust that as we go through a beautiful psalm this morning, that you will just have a sense of God's greatness, of His majestic power, and of His love for you, and that as a result of that, joy will just well up within you. And that no matter what happens today, no matter what you face today, the joy of the Lord will be your strength. Let's just pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are with us every moment. While we slept, we were in your sight, we were in your gaze. Thank you that your love just never ends, that your goodness and your mercy are constant. Lord, we bring to you this day and this time, and we ask, Holy Spirit, come and work in us, come and transform us, come and equip us for this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So Psalm 98 is the psalm for this morning, and it's a psalm of ascent. It speaks of God's goodness, God's greatness, of His victory, of His dealings with the Israelites. And the psalmist goes to lengths here to encourage us to praise Him and to worship Him and to do it in a celebratory way, speaking of God's goodness and of His greatness, of His great victories, what He has accomplished, what He is accomplishing, and what He will accomplish. It's conveniently broken into three sections, these nine verses of Psalm 98. And the first three are really addressed to the Israelite people. And the tone is of, come on, Israel, celebrate your God because His deeds are wondrous and known throughout the earth and throughout the world. Celebrate your God. Come and praise Him. And then the verses 4 to 6, the second part of the three parts, it's not only Israel, but come all humanity and come with instruments, come with musical instruments, the lyre, the harp, with wind instruments, come and celebrate, make a joyful noise to the Lord because of who He is and how wonderful He is and what He's accomplished. And then the last verses 7 to 9, not just humanity, but come all of creation, let the whole earth, let all that is in heaven and earth celebrate and praise God. So let me read that psalm and you'll recognize the three sections as I go through it. Sing a new song to the Lord, for He has done wonderful deeds. His right hand has won a mighty victory. His holy arm has shown His saving power. The Lord has announced His victory and has revealed His righteousness to every nation. He has remembered His promise to love and be faithful to Israel. The ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. So here we see that appeal to the nation of Israel to make known and to celebrate and to spread abroad God's greatness and to proclaim it and to remind themselves of who they are celebrating. And come and sing a new song. Come this day and sing a new song despite what is around you and what you're hearing maybe on the morning news. Come and sing a new song to the Lord because He is great. He's done wonderful things. And for the Israelites, that was out of Israel, the Exodus, wandering around in the wilderness, He showed His faithfulness to them, conquering into the land of Cana with Joshua and occupying the land. These are the things that make the Lord's name renowned, Yahweh, the God of the Israelites. And it's so interesting just to be reminded that this conqueror, this victor, this one who leads, this one who rescues, this one who saves is in the name of Joshua, Yeshua, And also Jesus, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus, the one who has won the victory for us. And that theme comes across so wonderfully in the first three verses, where in each of those three verses, victory is mentioned. Yeshua, victory, the one who rescues, the one who saves. Jesus, Joshua, our God. And then we look at the next section from verses 4 to 6. Shout to the Lord, all the earth. Break out in praise and sing for joy. Sing your praise to the Lord with a harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the ram's horn. Make a joyful symphony before the Lord the King. Here, the psalmist is just exalting us with all our creativity, with all our being, with all our enthusiasm. Come, not just the Israelites, come humanity, come all of us, and make a joyful noise to the Lord, to the King. Let's celebrate Him. And as we do this, we get a different perspective on our circumstances. As our focus is taken off the things around us and the world and the difficult things, it focuses on our Lord, the King. Come and celebrate. And celebrate as you go through this day. Don't worry about what anybody says to you, whether you sing an old chorus or a modern chorus. Sing your song to the Lord today. And it ends just as powerfully as this psalm kind of gathers in magnificence and in including different peoples. And here in the last three verses, it includes all of creation. Let the sea and everything in it shout his praise. Let the earth and all living things join in. Let the rivers clap their hands in glee. Let the hills sing out their songs of joy before the Lord. For the Lord is coming to judge earth. He will judge the world with justice and the nations with fairness. Come, all of creation, the depths of the ocean, the whale's song, the elements sing God's praise, nature, the trees. As we read in Isaiah chapter 55, and a well-known chorus, I think, to many of us, originates from Isaiah 55. For you shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing, and the trees of the fields will clap their hands. Come, let all of creation, everything in heaven and earth, praise God and bring him honor and glory today. What a wonderful God we serve. And as we do this, we begin to get a different perspective as we begin to focus on God and praise Him and lift Him up and remember who He is and how faithful He's been to us. We remember the past, we are strengthened for the present, and we're sure of the future. And Jesus is coming, His victory is triumphal coming. And this just changes our perspective, doesn't it? In fact, we might also be seeing as the poet or the psalmist here, with the trees and their branches being blown in the wind, almost like the clapping of hands. In this one, it says the rivers clap their hand. I think that really what it's saying is an exuberant celebration. All of nature, all of humanity, all of mankind, praise God, praise the Lord. Let us praise Him. For He is good. And I trust that you will have a song in your heart today as you go through this day. And it'll be a praise song to God for His goodness and His faithfulness to you and for the faithfulness that He will show to generations. So bless you this day. And I'm going to close in prayer. And then we'll listen to a chorus. And you may know this. And you're very welcome to sing it enthusiastically as you go out with joy. Let's pray together. Father, we want to celebrate you and praise you this morning because you are good. Your faithfulness endures forever. You indeed have done marvelous things. There is no name greater than your name. You are known throughout the earth. You speak and universes are formed. Jesus, you have won a great victory for us, set free from sin. You have a wonderful plan for all of creation to make all things new. Because you make all things new, no matter what our circumstances, we can sing a new song. So Father, bless us today. May your joy that comes from this wonderful God that you are and your great love for us and the working of you, Holy Spirit, within our lives, may that just bubble up from within us and change our whole perspective on this day and the days ahead. We ask this in your precious name, Jesus. Amen. God bless you.